Back with more extra points. This time we're talking about the SI Swimsuit Edition. It is February, yeah. And specifically golfer Paige Spiranac, who is ruffling feathers in the golf industry in general, and this appearance in the issue is sure to set another fire. The issue, if you want to call it that, with Spiranac is that she's not exactly an elite golfer.
No.
But she has a huge social media following, and a lot of that probably has to do with the sexy selfies and, I guess, not being afraid of showing off her good looks.
Yeah, it's the non-traditional clothing on the golf course that I think is really an issue here.
Yeah.
We can call this golf sexual revolution, if you will. Can we get away from the etiquette? And when it comes down to it, you know, what's she wearing on the golf course? Why is she getting this ridicule? I mean, she's wearing pants. She's wearing, you know, maybe showing a little bit of cleavage. Who cares? As long as she's following the guidelines set forth by the LPGA, I don't care if she ruffles her colleagues' feathers. Let her do what she wants.
I'll also say, too, she claims that she's on a crusade to change golf culture, and part of that has to do with bullying. She's been, you know, received death threats and just been bullied in general. And she says, hey, that's not cool, and so I can support that. Next, another subplot of the Super Bowl, and this one, as most things do, comes back to porn.
Yeah.
Pornhub alleges that usage in Massachusetts went up 26% in the few hours following the Super Bowl. So clearly these people were upset. They needed a get-me-up.
Yeah, first of all, is this still a sports show? Because a few of the topics here are, yeah, okay. But I want to know, okay, they say that it was down during the Super Bowl and then way up after the Super Bowl. What about during Pink's national anthem? Was it up then? Was it down then?
We need to know more.
The halftime show with Justin Timberlake, was it up or down then? Coming back to Pornhub, though, great advertising and marketing, because if anything, it's just kind of normalizing the usage that's widespread across the United States, obviously, and Canada.
And we get integral info like this. During the Super Bowl, searches for Tom Brady on Pornhub were up 1,200%.
Yeah, huge.
Next, off to the Olympics, where 229 North Korean cheerleaders arrived in South Korea to cheer on the Korean, the joint Korean team. That is just confusing me in general. And the odd thing about this is that number seems very high when their actual contingent of athletes is in the 20s.
I think it was just a chance for North Korea to have like the North Korean flag on there, to have some kind of representation.
Yeah.
The weird thing though is you look at these photos, they're getting off this bus, going into their hotel or wherever, and it's just kind of like, it's like they're wild animals.
They're celebrities.
They're more important than the athletes. What I want to know though is, you know, when are they going to plan the mass defection? Because if I'm coming from North Korea and I'm them, I look at this as an opportunity to get out.
Oh. Lastly, we leave you with the violent item of the day. We go to Georgia, across the world, to offer you some rugby action, some very physical, aggressive violence, and kicking, screaming, and punching.
We always talk about NHL players being tough. We always talk about gridiron, NFL, CFL players being tough. These are the real tough guys. And the best part about this area of the world is I have no doubt that after this punch-up, they probably finish the game.
Oh, yeah.